I'm here with one of the biggest legends in the history of boxing, the golden boy himself, Oscar De La Hoya. Oscar, you're a boxing legend, but tonight is the birthday of Muhammad Ali.
I can honestly say that the world loves him for what he's done. Inside the ring, outside the ring, you know, people, there's, you know, he was a somewhat of a controversial figure, right? Because of, at the time, what he stood for and this and that, but... Mm-hmm. If you think about it, Muhammad Ali, I mean, there is no doubt that he is the greatest. He is the greatest. Not only because he fought everybody inside the ring, and he had a great style. He was a boxer, but he knew how to knock somebody out. He just took boxing to a whole new level. And he knew how to captivate the fan all across the board. Not just your boxing fan, but the fan who loves boxing, who loves entertainment, who loves knockouts, who loves good fights.
I'm sure you had a chance to meet him over the years. What's your favorite memory with him, whether the Olympics or...
I actually have a funny story. We were receiving an award together at the Staples Center. And I walk into the room where he's at, sitting down with his family, and he sees me and he calls me over. And so I get close to him, and he says, "No, come closer, closer, closer." And so I'm literally right next to his ear, and he tells me, "You might be great, but I'm still prettier." Yeah, I mean, it was just a classic. I mean, he would say things that you just never expected.
All right, there you have it. Oscar De La Hoya, the legend, talking about Muhammad Ali. Stay tuned. EsNews.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach.
Well, you're talking about the greatest, man. I mean, in his prime, nobody beats Ali at heavyweight. But we never even saw Ali in his prime, because 67 to 71,
he sat out.
That was his best years. And he was such an active fighter. He would have broke Lewis's defense titles. There would have been no fight with Larry Holmes down the line. He would have been retired before all that happened. And he'd probably be on TV today doing commentary. You know, being an ambassador for the sport. He's an ambassador and all that. People still love him. But I miss the old Ali, the way he could handle the crowd and the way... just everything he did was magical.
What was your favorite Ali fight?
Cleveland Williams.
Why?
When he fought Cleveland Williams. The speed, the power, the timing, everything was going. The Thrill in Manila was a great fight, but that was a seesaw fight. It was a great historic fight, but when Ali fought Cleveland Williams, he was just about to peak, and that's when they took the title away from him and all that.
Maga, you're the first guy in my history that ever answered that question. Everybody says it's his Joe Frazier fight, his Foreman fight.
He was so good, but you got to remember one thing about Ali. Big, slow guys, strong guys, he beats them all day. Liston, Foreman, Cleveland Williams, Ron Lyle. Shavers he had problems with, but, you know, the guys that gave Frazier trouble, Ali trouble, Naughton and Frazier.
How would Ali do against Tyson? Tyson in his prime, Ali in his prime.
Please, he beats Tyson at the weigh-in, because Ali could get inside a guy's head. You know, just like Lennox Lewis got inside. I thought Lennox got inside Tyson. Because Tyson couldn't intimidate. If Tyson can't intimidate you, that's half the battle with him.
80%.
I mean, yeah, and when he fought Douglas, Douglas's dad, who was a pretty good fighter himself, told his son, "Hey, man, this is a boxing match. This ain't a street fight. This guy's not going to kick you and bite you." You know, and sure enough, Douglas put on a great show that night. And Tyson, that was up in the Catskills, he could have given anyone trouble. He had speed, he had power. Very seldom you see, of all the fighters, speed and power. Joe Lewis had it, Tyson had it, you know. Foreman wasn't fast. None of those
James
guys.
That's my favorite sports movie.
Who's your favorite fighter of all time? Is it Ali? Is it Mayweather? Is it Pacquiao? Is it...
Well, my favorite fighter is Muhammad Ali.
Why?
Because of what he did in the ring and outside of the ring. The way he was able to stand up and fight for his beliefs in a time and in an era of the 60s where America was going through a lot of civil unrest, racial unrest, and he was a man of that time, of that generation, who stood taller than any other athlete at that particular time. because he, you know, when we talk about paying the price, when we look at those 2-3 years in his prime that America took away, we don't know what those years would have been like and what he would have been able to do for this country in this world had he been allowed to be on stage and still have a voice.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.